Okay, this video is going to show you how to do the SketchUp assignment 2 on the online version of SketchUp. Now when you start off, you're going to have this lady here. Let's just right click and we're going to erase. Much like assignment 1, there's no defined measurements. So we're going to go and we're going to start with a rectangle. I'm not going to consult the instructions in the PDF file for this particular instructional tutorial. We're going to click once and we're going to pull this up and we're going to kind of move that over. You're going to go over and make sure you've got the 2-point arc. Click once, click twice, go over here. There's your half circle. Perfect. Let's go over to push-pull. Click once. Don't hold that button down. Click on this edge or this edge. You're basically using this edge. You're saying SketchUp, this is where I want it to end. This is going to save you a lot of trouble. Like someone's like, oh, I can get it. No, you can't. There you go. Now what you're going to do is you're going to go to the move option. Click on here. Don't hold it down. Just click once. Bring it down like so. Try and keep that front face straight. Click. And you want to end up something like that. Now I'm just going to go over here to undo. Now if you end up with a situation where you're like, it just wants to do this and this. It doesn't want to go down. What you want to do is, I'm going to undo that, is you're just going to quickly grab your pencil. Let's just draw a line, make sure it's straight. And what happens is this line now becomes a hinge. And you click once, let's just bring it over there, click, and now you've got the outcome that you're going to want. Let's just move this over, and that's what it looks like. Now the instructions want you to go over to the paint bucket now and we're going to apply some texture. So let's just go to materials and we're going to apply some different textures. So let's go, if it defaults to the house, let's go over here to the search, which is going to give you all the different options. So what we're going to do is we're going to apply some roofing. Let's go here and grab some roofing. You can use any roofing texture that you want. It's not going to have any bearing on your marks. I encourage you to collapse any drop-down menus once you're done with them, just because it makes things a little easier to manage. Let's go brick and cladding. Once again, brick texture is of your choice and your choosing. Now we've got all the stuff on there that we need. I'm going to collapse this. I don't want to have to look at it, but that's up to you. So now what we're going to do is we're going to zoom into this corner. Let's go over to our shapes and we're going to pick circle. And I'm going to make a circle like so. Do not touch this edge line or this edge line. If you do, you're going to create a world of problems in future steps. And now we're going to create a circle inside the circle. Once again, let's go back to our paint bucket. Let's collapse that. Let's go over to colors. Grab any color that you want. Once again, there's no marks in terms of you have to get a certain color. Let's go over to glass and mirrors. Pick any texture you want. Now we've got our circle. So what you want to do now is you want to go arrow. Let's put a window around this. Now to create the window, I'm holding down that left button on my mouse. Pretty much all the other steps, I just tell you to click once. For this one, we're going to actually hold that button down. We're going to right click and we're going to make that into a component. Now, if you want, you can create like a name for that component, or you can use the default. Okay, it's up to you. You can add all kinds of details. I would not really encourage you to change any of this stuff. Let's go click OK. It's now going to turn this into a component. Now if you go over to this option here, component, kind of scroll on up here, see it says components. Now if you click on the right hand side, it gives you the option to look for stuff in the 3D warehouse, which is a step that we're going to explore in later exercises. But for this one, we're going to click on in model. In model is going to show you all the components associated with your drawing. Now, Helen was that lady that we started out with, in different versions of different people. There's Chris and all kinds of people. Now, it also shows your circle, created by me. If you don't see this circle, that means you do not have a component. So you did not make it into a component. And for this particular step, this exercise, the component is a really essential part of the marking scheme. So let's just kind of collapse that. Let's scroll on back. And I'm going to go and I'm going to grab my move option and I'm going to hold the control key down. And the control key is CTRL. Mine's on the bottom left hand side. I'm holding that button right now. And I'm going to click the left button on the mouse once, click, and I'm going to bring it over and I'm going to click once again to drop that off. Now if you look at the bottom right hand corner of your screen or my screen, I'm going to hit slash 11 and enter. Now you can pick the number that you feel the copies are going to fit. Now if for whatever reason you end up with too many, they're all squished together, something like that, or not enough, just go down to here and undo and repeat that particular step. So I'm now gonna go over here. I'm gonna go move. I'm holding the control key down. I'm gonna put it here and I'm gonna put it up here on the top. Now for this demonstration, I am not going to fill the front. I'm not gonna fill the top and I'm not gonna complete the diagonal line of circles, okay? Consult the PDF file, please. Or just simply make sure that the front's filled with circles, the top's filled with circles, and this side here basically has this. Okay, that'll make sure that you get full marks. Now for the demonstration, I am going to copy this over. Let's just undo anything we don't want. So let's just go, once again, I'll leave that for you. Okay, so let's hold the control key down. Let's copy that circle. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to demonstrate one of the advantages of using the component. So I'm going to right click on here and I'm going to edit component. Note the difference in color. Please remember, when you make a component, after that process, any changes you want to make to that component have to be done in edit component mode. And now you're going to see why. So any changes you make to that component, all the other components are going to receive that change. So I'm going to go push pull and I'm going to pull that out. Note all the other components have that change. And you might say, well, you know, for one thing, that saves you time. But where might you use this? Good example, designing a house, lots of windows that are the same, and you only have to change one window if you have to make some changes. So now we're going to get to our final step, which is on the roof. You can pick one or more. It doesn't matter in terms of marks. I'm just going to pick one for the demonstration. I'm going to put a window around that. I'm going to go right click. I'm now going to click on make unique. I'm now going to go edit component. I'm now going to make a change to just that one component because it's now unique. It's not like the other ones. Okay, so let's go click, click, click. Let's erase that line. Let's erase that. Let's erase that line. And now we're going to push and pull the top up. Click like so. To get out of edit component mode, once again, just pick your arrow and click over here. And now this one component is unique and you've edited that unique component. So this pretty much shows you how to do assignment 2. Keep in mind you will have to consult the PDF file in terms of making sure that you fill this and fill this with circles. I hope that was helpful.